plots within plots, drama within drama, allegedly occurring inside the party that is ruling AIADMK. Apparently, sources claim all this because this party is having not one but two leaders. It's only trying to say that there can never be two swords in one place, and that is what apparently is has led to such a kind of drama within AIADMK. Now the party has two leaders after the death of the Supremo Jayalalitha. You could see in that picture, and the right side below Jayalalitha is Edappadi K. Palaniswamy, who is the chief minister of the state and second in command with the party as a co-convener. But on the left side you have O. Palaniselvam, who is the deputy chief minister of the state but the convener, which means a slightly upper hand. But however, anything to do with the party, both have to be the signatories. And allegedly in the past 6 months, when all plans and all everything that was sorted out for the pandemic situation, handling the situation, apparently importance was not given to the deputy chief minister O. Palaniselvam, and this his faction was not happy about. What occurred is that since August 15, the Independence Day, several round of talks has occurred about the CM candidature. The faction O. Palaniselvam's want him to be the next CM candidate. In fact, they call him as the heir apparent of Jayalalitha and the future CM. However, Chief Minister Edappadi Palaniswamy's faction claim that he is the permanent CM. Nobody wants to worry about the people's vote, but that's how he's being called by his faction. However, currently, after three rounds of talks, decision has been made that on 7th of October, the CM candidature will be announced at this location. This is AIADMK headquarters, by the chief minister and the deputy chief minister. Who will be the chief minister candidate? That is a big question. But sources within the party claim that O. Palaniselvam, after almost 3 months of struggle, has finally decided to go ahead and accept that Edappadi K. Palaniswamy could be the chief minister, for which all the MLAs have also been ordered slash invited by AIADMK headquarters to be in Chennai from 6th of October onwards. This seems to be the outward issue, but inside, even now, Edappadi K. Palaniswamy faction believes that a plot within a plot is there, and that O. Palaniselvam faction wants to take over the party, and for that is only O. Palaniselvam is demanding that the 11 member steering committee should be created to make sure that all decisions could be taken. Edappadi K. Palaniswamy faction still believes that a national party is actually causing influence with the decisions made by O. Palaniselvam, and there are high chances that the steering committee can also be easily influenced by the Delhi National Party, and that's the reason they are not ready to accept it. Amidst all this, O. Palaniselvam, the deputy chief minister, goes ahead and today tweets. He actually quotes lines from Bhagavad Gita claiming what has occurred has happened for good. What is happening is also happening for good, and what will happen will also happen for good. And he claims that all decisions he's taken so far is only for the welfare of Tamil Nadu and the AIADMK caterers, and his future decisions will all be made so. With camera person Vijay Shekhar, Pramod Madhav for Mirror Now.